The Elves and the Shoemaker. Once upon a time, there lived a poor shoemaker. Though he was honest and hardworking, he never made enough money. He and his wife ran the household with great difficulty. Sometimes all they had to eat was a piece of bread. The shoemaker saved some money and finally had enough to buy a piece of leather. He could make only one pair of shoes with it. He decided to make the shoes the next day. So, he prepared the leather that night and left it ready on the table of his workroom. He slept happily that night, thinking of the pair of shoes he would make the next day. In the morning, after he had a slice of toast for breakfast, he entered his workroom. On his work table stood a beautiful pair of fancy shoes. The shoemaker was completely taken aback. He rushed to call his wife. When he told her what he had seen, she could not believe him. So the shoemaker brought his wife to the room, and she was amazed to see the shoes. The shoemaker took the shoes in his hands, admiring the neat and tidy stitches. He had tears in his eye. He thanked God for this miracle and set the pair on the window shelf. A rich merchant was passing by the shoemaker's window. When he spotted the attractive pair of shoes, he went inside and bought them, paying a handsome price. After such a long time, the shoemaker and his wife had a proper meal that day. That evening, the shoemaker bought enough leather to make two pairs of shoes. He cut and shaped the shoes with great love and care. By the end of the evening, he was tired. He laid everything out and left the room. He thought that he would come back the next morning to complete the work. The next morning, the shoemaker woke up early. He bathed and prayed, ate his humble breakfast, and then stepped into the room where he worked. Lo and behold, once again, he found two stylish pairs of shoes waiting for him on his work table. With a prayer on his lips and a tear in his eye, the shoemaker once again thanked God for his fortune. That day, two more rich clients bought the shoes at a very good price. Again, the shoemaker bought more leather and left it in the room. The next day, he found four pairs of attractive new shoes on his work table. This went on for some time. Soon, the shoemaker became quite rich. He could buy lots of leather and make many pairs of shoes at once. Before Christmas, the shoemaker's wife suggested they find out who was helping them with the shoes that night. So, the couple hid behind the curtain of the workroom and stood in absolute silence. Right after midnight, the window opened and two small elves entered the rooms. They were dressed in dirty and torn clothes. They sang and hummed to themselves and worked on the pieces of leather that were sitting on the table. The shoemaker and his wife were so grateful that they nearly came out of their hiding place and thanked them. But they did not move so as not to scare the elves. The next day, the shoemaker and his wife cut bits of cloth and made little clothes for the elves. That night, they put the new clothes on the work table and left the room. After a while, the elves came, as usual, looking for the pieces of leather that the shoemaker would have left behind. But instead, they found two new sets of clothes for themselves. The elves were extremely happy. They took the clothes and jumped through the window, singing and dancing merrily. The shoemaker and his wife thanked them silently. The shoemaker now had enough money, and he could employ a few men to work for him. He was never poor again. Though the elves never came back, the shoemaker and his wife knew they were somewhere helping other poor people.